Hello YouTube, it is a wonderful afternoon, sun and clear sky, decent temperature, really nice. So it's time to start backfilling here for the building. But I will not do that today. I'll check the weather forecast. It was a sunny nice day today, but as far as the forecast is, there will be rain every day. So this is not the work I will do when it's raining. I will take the opportunity to do some work on the digger. I will bring up the bucket so we can see. It is about this hydraulic tongue, and I absolutely love it. That is a problem though, because I also have this bucket here and I have one hydraulic outlet, but then now I need two devices, so I cannot work with that. I will install a switch valve that can switch between this hydraulic thumb and the tilt bucket here. I think it's called a divider valve or maybe a selector valve, and it is meant just exactly for this, that switch between two devices when there is only one, shall we say, supply line. I have those connectors here, and even if I have a cap on here, there is some, well, sand and all stuff that still goes in back into the hydraulic tank, and so I will install a filter that filters out that. Maybe that can prolong the life of this machine. Yeah, and I said that the forecast says rain for 10 days, so I will bring it into my unfinished garage. It doesn't fit, the opening is too low. So let's start by peeking in from the top. That is what it looks like, and here is the filter that I've installed. It sits on the return of the hydraulic fluid, so there isn't very much pressure, maybe 5 bars at the most. I also got a pressure meter so I can see when it is kind of full. It's the next day. At least I didn't lie. It started to rain here an hour ago. I have removed the side panels and the floor. It wasn't too difficult. A number of screws and so. I couldn't get this one off completely. It is pinched in there in some way. Anyways, here is the hydraulic valve package. We need to have a look at that one. Here are the joysticks and so. They go on top of the valves here, the individual valves. Not too important right now. What's important is that this is the inlet, high pressure side, coming from the pump, hydraulic pump. And this is the exit, the outlet. This is the low pressure side. And when we talk about installing the filter, so this one should go between this point here and the tank. So it will filter the oil that goes to the tank. So let's follow that line. It goes in here. That's the one, goes here, and right there, it's almost impossible to see, but I'll give a better shot. You see the hydraulic tank there, pick up for the hydraulic pump there, and here is the return, there it comes. So that is the one on top there. And here comes an additional line, so there are two return lines. I think this comes from relief valves for the swing motor and for the tracker motors. So what I need to do is I need to go from there to the filter. And I focus a little bit on the hoses here because I need to buy new ones. And it's important that they have the right length and they have the right connectors in the end. And they are not so easy to bend, so I kind of had to get it right from the start. Two rainy days later, I'm out here at the machine again. I will try to connect here. I will split this connector and put the filter in between there. That's the idea now. See if that is even possible. Yes. Something like this, perhaps. And, I can have a return line going down there, so I can have lift it up a bit, so perhaps. Yeah, that is good, I think. So I can make a bracket from that point there. So here. And you know what this is? It's an improvement from that tape measure that everyone has. Stiffen it up so it doesn't bend anymore. What can we say there? 60. Going to be out a bit there. 40 in the middle, 45 in the middle. Yeah. Another day has gone by. We have had a lot of rain, so yeah, that's good. Thanks to the wonders of downloadable step files and 3D models, I have now wasted a full day on waiting for the 3D printer to print out plastic parts. It would have been better to do them right away. Anyways, so this is about what I want to have it. There should be a little mark there now. It is. It's like a wet towel over everything. So I think the position there wasn't too good there. I think I will adjust it like this, but down here a bit. Doesn't have to be so high up. That's how far we are. Well, not too bad. 12 centimeters, I would guess. New bracket. Over here with the clearance. I used a smaller banjo fitting right now, so I think this one would work, or I can have that. So I used this one before. Anyways, this seemed fine. Yeah, this will work. I can have it like this for sure. Aha, it's one of those smaller, this type. Should go straight in there. This will not help. And this will not work. I have to lower it a little bit, and then I think it will work. It will touch in there, so when I do it for real, I think I will have to bend it a little bit there, so it is. I don't want it to touch into this one. So it will run in there, that is for sure. Maybe I should give up and move this one a bit. Move it out. This bracket isn't terribly strong. I think I will try to see if I can just bend it over there. I will do that off camera because this will be so nasty. What do you know? Has to really practice other techniques here when a camera is middle in the middle of the face. That one is tight. So yeah, that was fine. Yeah, it will sit here and vibrate, but it will be much different when you come here with a steel bracket. But there is no limitation now, so I can actually go back to lower it down quite a bit more there if I like to. Do I like that? Yeah, so it will take almost 3 hours to get a new version of this bracket. Well, in the meantime, I will measure up the length of the hoses. There we go. Exactly there. Where is now my measurement stick? So 47 center to center. Yeah. So the first one was 47 center to center, 34. So let's make that bracket in steel instead. Well, that was such a small thing, not even worth mentioning. Now we go again. I got the holes there for free, and the other side of the bracket, just two holes. Too nice there, but it was alright. Here it is. I'll just cut it apart, weld it together and put it here. But I don't like this. But this annoys me over all boundaries. I thought I could live with it, but I don't think that will happen. I have to do something there. Perhaps I can place one of those there. Cannot run into that one and not into that one. I think that would be fine. Something like that, I think, will be fine. Thank you. Oh, this was even worse. That was a right bender. It has to go that way. Can you do that? Okay, not, it's all right. But in all seriousness, then the other position would also work. Check out, I got the hoses and the fittings. And some nice flexible hoses. These are low pressure hoses because this is the return line and doesn't need to have more than a few bars. That is 20 bars. That should be right. So I plan to have the flow like it should go through the filter from the source, through the filter and to the tank. But for some reason it is the other way, so that the flow will come from the valves and all that cylinders up here, go through the filter and down to the tank. So I mean, it doesn't matter, but it surprised me more or less when I noticed that. In general, it is a little bit tight for it here, and it is difficult to find a good spot, but it sits pretty good there. There is some clearance there, some clearance over here. The throttle wire can go there. I have a way to look at the pressure. So I think that is fine. And all the hoses, they reach down to the tank and to the existing hose. But I saw that it was a little bit short, this hose there. So I will take this bracket instead. I'll take the dimensions of this bracket instead, which is just 2 centimeters longer. And I think that can make all the difference. But it's time to fixate this, to finally do this one in steel and to remove this one. It's a good attempt, but well. So the filter is here. I think all fittings are tightened up. It should be all right. I guess I have to test it. I should fill this one with oil. That is my impression. Can I do that from outside? Yeah, I can do that at least this time. Yeah. Here it is, overfilled of course, so I cannot get it in, or no, I could get it in. Yeah. I should tighten it. Strangely enough, I got a tool with a digger. Maybe I can use that. So I did get this one, maybe that one works. Awfully tight as always. Maybe it's better up here. Yeah, it is. Ah, it works. The simplest or the best. I thought the pressure there was a little bit high there, but I mean, it's a brand new filter and all, so I mean, it should be like that, I guess. I still have that selector valve to fix. That will be next video. But this is all for this video. Thanks for watching.